സോ ഇന്ന് നമ്മുടെ കൂടെ ഉള്ളത് വളരെ സ്പെഷ്യൽ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരാളാണ്. ഷീസ് എ വെരി ഫേമസ് ഇന്ത്യൻ ഡാൻസർ. ഷീസ് ആക്ച്വലി ദി ഓൺലി ഇന്ത്യൻ ഡാൻസർ ഹു ഈസ് എൻ അലുംനസ് ഓഫ് ബോത്ത് ശാന്തി നികേതൻ ആൻഡ് കേരള കലാമണ്ഡലം. ഓക്കെ, ഇപ്പൊ തന്നെ ആരെ പറ്റിയാ പറയുന്ന ഒരു ഐഡിയ വന്നിട്ടുണ്ടാവും. ഐ എം ടോക്കിംഗ് അബൌട്ട് ശ്രീമതി പല്ലവി കൃഷ്ണൻ, വൺ ഓഫ് ദി ലീഡിംഗ് എക്സ്പോണൻസ് ഓഫ് മോഹിനിയാട്ടം. ഹായ് മാം, വെൽക്കം ടു ക്വാറന്റൈൻ.
ഹലോ.
ഹലോ മാം. ഓക്കെ, സോ മാം ആക്ച്വലി ഒരു ബംഗാളിലെ നേറ്റീവ് ആണ് അല്ലെ? സോ അവിടുന്ന് കേരളത്തിലേക്ക് വന്നപ്പോൾ മാമിന് ആ കൾച്ചറിൽ ഡിഫറൻസ് തോന്നിയോ, അതോ ഇവിടുത്തെ ലൈഫ് പോയി അഡ്ജസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ട് തോന്നിയോ? ഹൗ ഡിഡ് യു ഫീൽ?
See, when I came to Kerala, I came as a student with a lot of dreams in my eyes and a lot of passion. So adjustment angle to the problem because I came for a purpose. Okay. So when I landed in Kerala and then I joined Kalamandalam, yes, I faced a lot of hurdles and problems regarding language, mainly language and food. Food habits very different from Kerala and West Bengal has a lot of differences. But I did not actually find a lot of I enjoyed my stay in Kerala Kalamandalam. After that, because at that time I was staying only in the hostel. So I did not know the outside outside culture of Kerala, actual culture of Kerala. But when I got married and I came out of hostel and started staying in the society, then I realized that it is quite different from what we have in West Bengal. But I was so involved in my with my passion and with my career and with my love, that is dance. I, even though I faced a lot of hurdles, I could overcome it. And now I totally enjoy Kerala, living in Kerala.
Ma'am, ma'am's family supportive ആയിരുന്നു dance ആണ് മാഡത്തിന്റെ കരിയർ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ സമയത്ത്?
Family means എന്റെ അച്ഛനമ്മ.
Yeah.
I come from an academic family. In the family, artist aarum illa. Everybody is academician. So my father is an engineer. I have a lot of doctors and engineers and all in my family. I'm the only one who has taken art as a profession. So I did not have any idea about an artist's life, or neither my parents had. So what happened that they actually did not have any idea what I was going to do, but they supported me because they believed in me. So when I decided to take dance as my career or take forward, and that will be the only thing I will pursue in my life, when I decided that immediately after my 12th grade, then my father was very particular that I should finish my academic graduation, and I finished my graduation in bioscience botany. Then he let me take my own chase my passion. So then I joined another course in Shantiniketan. That's it. And so after that, they supported me. I'm so lucky to have very supportive parents. Very supportive parents.
Yes, ma'am, you're very lucky.
Yeah.
So, ma'am, ഇപ്പൊ ഒരു ഡാൻസ് അക്കാഡമി ഉണ്ട് അല്ലെ? So, ആ ഒരു ടീച്ചർ എന്നുള്ള ഒരു ലൈഫ് അതെങ്ങനെയാണ്?
Basically, I'm a performer.
Yeah.
First comes my performance, then teaching. But teaching is must, because through teaching you learn a lot. Once I started teaching, I started learning more. I learned so many things from my students. Suppose I choreograph something in my own way. When I teach my students, when they do it in a little bit of different way, I find it very, sometimes I find it very interesting. I think that, okay, this is, oh, this way it could be done. And then a lot of experiments I can do with my students. And that actually, that process, I get enriched through that process. So I learn a lot. So that's why I love teaching. At the initial stage, you know, you need to have a financial support. Like through teaching, you can earn. And also you are sharing your knowledge with the students, and you are also earning so that you can create more things. You need money to create. So yeah, so from performance, from teaching, whatever you earn, you spend that for new creations. So that is very, very important. And when you are sharing your knowledge with your students, that is a wonderful experience. And now at this age, at this stage, when I see my students, blossoming into beautiful dancers, when they started, when they were very young, at their very tiny age, and then they continued with me, and slowly they are blossoming into beautiful artist dancers, that gives me an immense satisfaction. So that is my experience in teaching, you can say. It's not only just teach items after items. I have a very special relationship or connections with my students.
മാം ഇപ്പോ ഇവിടെ പെർഫോമൻസസ് ചെയ്യാറുണ്ട്, അബ്രോഡ് ചെയ്യാറുണ്ട്. സോ പുറത്തു പോകുമ്പോ അവിടെയുള്ള ആൾക്കാരുടെ ഒരു റിയാക്ഷൻ എങ്ങനെയാണ്, അവരുടെ റെസ്പോൺസ് ഇന്ത്യൻ ക്ലാസിക്കൽ ഡാൻസ് ഫോംസിനോട്?
I think their response is better, because you know why? There, all the programs are ticketed program. They pay money.
Yeah.
When they come to see a performance, they buy ticket. They spend a lot. So when you spend money to watch something or to get something, you try to get it full, and you also value it more.
Yeah, that's true. Free
item. Yeah. Free item. Ellam performance is free. So what happens is they don't value it. Once it is ticketed, then you start valuing it more. I think in India, classical performance, whatever performances, it should be ticketed. You should, everybody is, can afford a minimum amount of money. It's, you go to a restaurant, you spend a lot. You spend a lot to buy a dress. Why don't you spend a little bit to watch a performance? So once you spend a little bit, you start valuing it more. So that is the reason that in abroad, no program is free. Not even a single program is free. All programs are ticketed. So that is the difference I find here and there.
Yes. Okay, ma'am. So, ma'am, in your favorite dancer, undo? Idol.
Yes. Yes. My favorite dancer. I have many favorite dancers, but if you ask me, whom I consider as the inspiration, from whom I get all kind of energy by watching, by thinking about that dancer, that is Guru Padma Subramanian, undoubtedly. Because I lived in a small place. In my childhood, I did not have much opportunity to see many performances, great performances, because my father was an engineer. And he worked in a thermal power station, and that's why the place where we lived was a bit away from the main city. Okay, so there I did not have much opportunity to see performances. I did not have much opportunity. Did not have much options to learn dance in my childhood. So. At that time, when the TV came, we had only one national channel. There, I used to watch national programs of dance, and there I started watching more dance through in TV. And there used to be a series which Guru Padma Subramaniam was doing, and she was every Sunday it used to come, that series, and she was giving lecture demonstration on the nuances of Natashastra, which is a dance, what do you say, that like Bhagavad Gita in Hindu.
Okay.
Yeah, like kind of, yeah, that is the Shastram that we follow, a text we follow. So she was giving lecture demonstration on that nuances of Natashastra every Sunday. And it was so good, so enriching. And I was like, that was when that I decided that, okay, this is amazing and I want to do something, take this dance as in future, and that should be my career, or I want to pursue on dance. After watching that episodes or that program, I decided. So what happened from that time itself, I admire her like anything. Until today, she is my favorite dancer. And she is the best.
Yes. Okay. So, ma'am, ഇപ്പൊ ഒരുപാട് പേര് എനിക്ക് തന്നെ അറിയാം ഡാൻസ് വളരെയധികം ഇഷ്ടമാണ്, പക്ഷെ അതൊരു കരിയറായി ചൂസ് ചെയ്യാൻ ഒരു പേടി അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ഉള്ള ഒരുപാട് അസ്പയറിംഗ് യങ് ഡാൻസേഴ്സ് ഉണ്ട്. സോ ഇവർക്ക് മാമിന് കൊടുക്കാനുള്ള ഒരു മെസ്സേജ് എന്തായിരിക്കും?
It's not easy. ഞാൻ ഇതിൽ എടുത്തു കാണാൻ എനിക്ക് ഇതിൻ്റെ ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ടീസ് ഓർ ദ പാത്ത് ഈസ് സോ ഡിഫിക്കൾട്ട് അത് അറിയില്ലായിരുന്നു. ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ജസ്റ്റ് ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് മൈ പാഷൻ ദാറ്റ് ഐ ചോസ് ദിസ് പാത്ത്, ആൻഡ് ഐ എം സോ ഗ്ലാഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഐ ചോസ് ദിസ് പാത്ത്. ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് ഈസി, ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി ഡിഫിക്കൾട്ട്. ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി ഡിഫിക്കൾട്ട്. ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ, huge competition, then it's like you have to be totally, totally dedicated. You have to dedicate your whole life for the art to achieve something, to achieve your goal. Otherwise, you are not, there is no shortcut in this field, that in art or any field. I think you have to give your best, you have to give your everything, like the whole life. So yeah. When you face those kind of problems that you are not getting performances, or you are not, even though you are good, you are not getting recognition, or those are the times that it's very tough, and this is the time that most of the dancers give up. If you can pass that phase, and then after that it's nice. So to cross that phase is very, very difficult, and you have to practice and practice and practice and practice. So not many people are lucky to get supportive parents. Not many are lucky to have a supportive husband family. So that is why most of the many dancers give up. But some, I also have some students who give more priority to studies. At the moment they are in 9th or 10th standard, they think that going to dance class is a waste of time. So I don't know, once 1 hour in a week, if you go for a dance class or any class, music class or anything, so how it can be a waste of time, or how it is going to affect your studies. I think it should have a positive impact in your life, in your studies. You get more concentration. I try to tell my students, some understand, some don't understand. So but I get some students, elderly students, who come and tell that we made a mistake, that we stopped dance when we were in 9th 10th standard, thinking that it will have a it is taking away our time, precious time, which we can give for our studies. But now we feel that what a big mistake we have done, we want to restart. I get many students like that. So So I tell my younger students, see, this you will also regret one day if you just stop, just because you think that it is taking away your time and studies. So it's not actually true. I have students who came to practice, you know, just a previous day of their of her. I have two students who came to dance just to relax, because they felt they are fatigued. So they came to me, they danced previous day of their, you know, CBSE maths exam. I have students like that also. So yes, it depends. Yes. So I want to tell the young children, the students, or those who are learning not only dance, any art form, but please don't give up. Take forward your studies and arts simultaneously.
Definitely.
Yeah, talent eppozhum That is a, you know, not everybody get the talent. Not everybody have the monetary support, or not everybody has that the supportive parents.
Yeah,
it is all kittittu value chain illa. Value cheyumpo, when they feel that, okay, what a big, you know, we lost something, appo time is over. Oruvaade time poi kaiyunu appo adu tirichu vannitte aa oru adu pick up cheyan, it's not easy.
Okay, ma'am. So I guess it's almost time to wind up. Ma'am, ide oru paada online workshops um ella karyangalum undu nariya. Adinte idayile korchu samayam njangalkku vendi maati vechayin oru paada nanni. Thank you so thank much you. For joining us.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting
me. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you so much.